his mannerisms of when he was coming up with promos, and his biggest regret in his career. Howdy, hey there, and hello. It's time for post-natural disaster temporary housing, a watch that syncs with GPS satellites, a Super Mario Brothers speed run in under 5 minutes, and Foley pins Jericho! Foley pins Jericho! Foley pins Jericho! I'm your host, Montez McCrary, the practitioner, and welcome to episode 107 of Wired, bringing you the nerdy geekery in architecture, technology, video games, and professional wrestling. Anyways, stories. With memories of Hurricane Sandy and Katrina still fresh, temporary post-disaster relief housing is needed and absolutely necessary. So New York City Office of Emergency Management and Garrison Architects developed modular, prefabricated housing meant to relieve displaced citizens after a natural disaster. The urban post-disaster housing prototype program units, demonstrated with a prototype unit in Brooklyn, are prefabricated multi-story, multi-family, interim housing solutions that measure at roughly 40 feet by 100 feet long, and they contain a kitchen, bedroom, bathroom, and storage spaces, and will work in urban areas of practically any city across this country. The current prototype in Brooklyn, designed by Garrison Architects, will be tested in the coming months by city officials and local universities. And within the next few weeks or so, a gallery will be opened inside the resilient and modular house, explaining the project's development process to the public. While these are much better temporary housing options than shelters, hotels, and tents, they could also serve as possible permanent housing under different types of guidelines. So, win-win, Garrison and NYC. My only problem with the awesomeness that is mechanical watches is inaccuracy, because even quartz watches with a number of gears and springs, they'll typically be incorrect on getting the correct time every now and then. But how about a mechanical watch that syncs to GPS satellites up in space with the press of a magic button? VCXO recently released information on their new Ox One watch, which features a built-in battery charged by weights inside of the watch that power the mechanical and automatic gear movements, with the latter automatically syncing with GPS satellites with the press of the magic button. Yes, they're calling it that, and it's located on the side of the watch. So instead of a winding crown, the magic button sets the watch via GPS. But if there's no GPS connectivity, the watch will just set itself to an internal clock. Plus, the mechanical part of the Ox One watch is actually a TT-738 from Swiss Technotime SA, a watch movement supplier. Pictures are pretty gorgeous, huh? Well, be wary of its price, as the Ox One will set you back a whopping $41,000. Yeah, I'm gonna stick to my fossil. Thank you very much. What I love about watching speedrun videos is that they showcase how someone can easily breeze through a game that probably took the rest of us peasant gamers hours, days, weeks, months, and sometimes years to complete. Or in the case of this one speedrunner, under 5 minutes. A speedrunner nicknamed Blubber beat the classic Nintendo Entertainment System video game Super Mario Brothers in a playthrough that only took him a bewildering 4 minutes and 57 seconds to complete. Dang. And Blubber beat the prior record set by Andrew G at 4 minutes and 58 seconds. And how did Blubber shave off that pesky 1 second? Well, he found some tricks, notably the bullet bill glitch in World 8-2, which allowed him to just skip along the walk to the castle. And if you're wondering, the timer begins when the in-game timer appears in World 1-1 and stops when Mario lands on the axe in World 8-4. Now, if you excuse me, I'm gonna set a speedrun record to beat Super Ghouls and Ghosts on the Super Nintendo. And no, it's not cheating, it's a trick. I'm just finding it. Last year, Mick Foley was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame in New York City on the night before WrestleMania 29. But during his induction speech, Foley talked about his days in the gym, his mannerisms of when he was coming up with a promo, and his biggest regret of his career, which is never pinning Chris Jericho. As Foley kept talking about never pinning Jericho, Chris Jericho himself climbed onto the stage, suit and all, and lied down for Foley to pin him. And not too far behind him was CM Punk, who would also climb onto the stage while sporting a bald head in a suit, almost making him unrecognizable, to act as the, you know, the de facto referee. First, Foley contemplated on whether or not to drop an elbow on Jericho, as he was unsure if he could physically pull it off without hurting himself. So as Foley gingerly walked toward the lion Chris Jericho, at the very last second, Foley then dropped an elbow on Jericho, and Punk made the three count, putting this industry travesty to rest once and for all. And not only do I love Chris Jericho for coming back to put over new rising talent, now he's putting over Hall of Famers. Is there nothing this guy won't do for the good of the business? Nothing at all. Nothing at all. So thanks for tuning in, everybody. Please like, love, share the video, add to your favorites, subscribe to the Practitioner channels on Blip, YouTube, and iTunes. And you can follow me on all the social networks. Check out thepractitioner.com for further story details. And if you have an opinion or something you'd like to share in their ad, feel free to leave a comment down below this video as well as on thepractitioner.com. You can support The Practitioner by clicking on the Amazon link below and shop on Amazon like you normally would, because you'll be helping out the channels and the website. So before I go, I'll see you guys next time. But until then, be sure to stay true to yourselves, stay blessed, and stay nerdy.